Want to discover some of the best food that Puerto Vallarta and area has to offer? Come along with me, and I'll show you some lesser-known secrets. First off is Birria González 3. During my 6-month stay in New Mexico, I came to love birria and its rich consommé. Birria González 3 shares their space with a bar and a car wash. Just down the street from Birria González is Sinaduría y Tamales Mangiana. Their pozole is the best I've tasted yet in Mexico, with enough flavor to keep me coming back. Traditional pozole is garnished with fresh cabbage, radishes, onions, lime, and served with tostadas or tortillas. The 2023 Brewmasters Festival exposed me to some vendors I wouldn't normally have found. Churros Imelda was one of those. I find it fascinating to watch how the churros are made, don't you? Imelda and Jorge's churro business is geared for catering to events like this one. The next stop barely made it on my list, but it's not because of the flavor or atmosphere. Alambrado Mariscos y Tacos is truly a hidden gem. I literally just found it on an evening stroll. They serve seafood on the weekends and I plan to go back. Where I did find seafood was at La Casa da Mahoma. I must admit, this guy wielding a machete, prepping oysters outside the colorful restaurant drew me in. Visitors enjoy generous portions of seafood, delicious michelada botanera, and great service in a relaxed, kid-friendly atmosphere. If you notice, there's even a trampoline in the back. Just outside of a hardware store, on Calle Obelisco, my friend Marta's taco stand deserves much recognition. La Muchacha Alegra has earned a great reputation here among the locals, with many friends and family visiting for lunch each day. The best day is Friday, when Marta serves her famous ceviche and tititos de camarón y pescado. Another hidden treasure? La Pasadita is located beside the Pharmacy Guadalajara on Calle Exquisito Corona. I could live on their birria consomme. It's so delicious. Like many others on this list, I had to add them to Google Maps to make it easier to find them. Situated on a hilltop, perfectly poised to view the sunsets, lies Las del Puerto. Generous servings of burgers, fries, and my favorite, agua fresca, gives taste buds a satisfaction that they crave. Parking is limited, and the climb on cobblestone streets may be difficult for some, so I advise arriving by taxi or ordering for takeout. Mako City Chai is a great place to get your morning started. I'm excited to try the weekend brunch buffet on my next visit. When I tried chicken from Rosticería Mi Pollo for the first time, I knew I had found something very special. Their rotisserie chicken is tender, never dry, and flavored with the most delicious blend of spices. Restico Cocina del Mar y Brasas is another vendor I visited at Brewfest. Their grilled octopus caught my attention, and I indulged in some delicious tacos de pulpo while enjoying the festival. Back in my neighborhood, Tacos Chuy was one of my favorite places to eat late-night tacos adobada. My friend Edwin welcomes all his guests at his street-side venue and serves agua fresca with tacos adobada y tripa. Three are located outside the city, but they're definitely worth the trip. First, we traveled to Playa Las Animas to sample some of Aaron's tasty seafood at El Corral. Enjoying all of this delicious food and drink on the pristine beach was a real treat. El Corral is one of the main sponsors of the Banderas Bay project, which maintains the hiking trails from Boca de Tomatlan to Playa Las Animas. Head inland to El Chuito with me to discover these last but not least two places. Located on Mexico Highway 200, El Tacos Amigos serves delicious tacos, and as an added bonus, the menu has English on one side. Beto's Burger Bar offers fresh salads, burgers, wings, and barbecue ribs, as well as a place to watch the game and enjoy some beverages. Plus, we can't forget all the smaller street vendors who sell just one item, like Adele's Agua Fresca and Jose's Watermelon. I I hope you've enjoyed this small glimpse into the cuisine of Puerto Vallarta. There were too many to list. Have you tried any of these places? Am I missing any? I want to hear from you in the comments. And please don't forget to like and subscribe for more.